wasting time. I think lyrics need to rhyme, and you're not asking, but I'm trying to grow a mustache. I eat cheese, but only on pizza, please, and sometimes on a homemade quesadilla. Otherwise, it smells like feet to me, and I really like you when the moon looks like a toenail, and I love you when you say my name.
The Elephant's Child. Many, many years ago, elephant had short little noses. They did not have trunks. They could move their noses from side to side, but they could not pick anything up with their noses. They were happy this way. They did not know any better. But there was one elephant that changed everything. He was not a wise old elephant as one might seem. He was just a child. He was the elephant's child.
He lived in Africa with many different animals, and he was curious. Curious with capital C. He wanted to know everything. He asked a lot of questions, and his family got tired of hearing them.
On the street, why do you have such a long tail feathers?
I don't know. Stop asking so many questions.
Uncle Giraffe, why do you have so many spots?
I don't know. Stop asking so many questions.
Uncle Baboon, why does melon taste so good?
I don't know. Stop asking so many questions. Go away.
Auntie Hippo, why are your eyes red?
Angel, I don't know. Stop asking so many questions.
Auntie Baboon, why does the melon taste so good?
Don't know. Stop asking so many questions. Go away.
The elephant child asks questions about everything. Everything he saw or felt or touched or heard or smelled. One day, he asked a new question.
Hi, Auntie Uncle. I have one question again. What does the crocodile eat for dinner?
All of the animals said if the crocodile was dangerous, but the elephant child still wanted to know the answer. The elephant child went to see the deer and asked his question.
Dear, can I ask you a question? Are you afraid of crocodiles? Then what crocodile eats?
I am afraid of the crocodile too. You should not ask these questions. But if you truly want to know the answer, you must go to the Great Green River and ask the crocodile.
The next morning, the elephant child said goodbye to his family. He took some snakes. It was a lot to carry, but elephants are strong. The elephant child was going on a long trip. He would need a lot of food.
It was a very walk, but Africa is a beautiful. The elephant child saw many beautiful things as he walked along. He even saw the pig.
Excuse me, does the crocodile live near here?
The elephant child had never seen the crocodile before. He didn't know what they looked like. He didn't know much about them at all. And for this reason, he wasn't afraid. He had never seen their sharp teeth. He didn't know how tricky they could be. He didn't know how dangerous the crocodile were.
Ha ha, this question you so not ask. Who's little open?
Piton. The piton also afraid of the crocodile. The 11th child continued walking. Finally, he got to the grey green river. It was very muddy and he accidentally kicked a log.
My foot!
Your foot? What about me? You kicked me! Ah!
The elephant child looked down and saw that the log wasn't locked.
I'm sorry I kicked you. I don't know where you are. I'm looking for the crocodile. Have you seen him?
I am the crocodile.
Really? You are Mr. Crocodile? I found the crocodile. Mr. Crocodile, I have a question for you.
What? I cannot hear you.
What should I say? I forget. Oh, yeah. Mr. Crocodile, what do you eat for dinner?
Come closer. I'll tell you. It's a secret.
What is this? What is that?
So the elephant child got down on his kicks and put his hand right next to the crocodile mound. Then the crocodile bit the elephant child on his short little nose and between his teeth.
Today I think I will start with the elephant child. That's what I'll eat for dinner today.
Burning me! No! Somebody help me! Help me!
Pull if you can. If you don't, the crocodile will eat you.
I'm trying to pull. Help me, somebody!
The elephant child pulled, and the crocodile pulled the other way. They both pulled and pulled. And the 11th child nose got longer and longer. Then the 11th child starts sleep in the mood. The crocodile was going to win. The 11th child was going to become dinner.
The python saw it all. He hurried down and turned himself around the elephant's back legs. The python and the little elephants pulled together against the mighty crocodile. The crocodile let go of the elephant's nose. He sank back into the mud and swam away. He did not get his dinner.
Thank you so much, Mr. Piton.
They were proud of themselves for beating the crocodile.
Hush, look at this. This is so long.
His short little noses was now straight into a long trunk.
It looks quite good.
I hope it's rained back. Look at this.
The 11th child wanted to for his trunk to shrink. He wanted for 3 long days. At the end of the 3rd day, a fly bit him on the shoulder. Before he even knew what he was doing, he lifted up his trunk and killed the fly.
What a great nose! Now, press something.
Without standing up, the elephant child reached out with his trunks, grabbed a bunch of grass, and put it in his mouth.
I said, what a great nose.
The python was right. His new nose was great. The elephant child started to like his new nose very much. Then suddenly, he thought about his family back home.
Mr. Piton, thank you for all of your help. You're kind and brave. But now, I think I must go home. I miss my family, me so much.
So, the python and the little elephant said their goodbye. And the elephant child start the long walk home.
Bye, Mr. Piton.
Okay.